I could let you have it. You could be my heaven. You could be my woman, right? I don't want you having. Anytime I know you're living in
the yes, no cheese, please.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you. Alright, what's up guys? It's been a really long week of school, so how are you guys doing? Alright, so as usual, here are a few highlights from the past 1 week. I was really late for school the other day, so I just had my Zoom lessons in the car. And we also found an insanely comfortable relaxer in the school library, so I think I'm gonna be studying a lot more often there for now. So as usual, me and my group mates, we were really swamped with projects for the past week, but we have already submitted 2 of the reports last night, so it's gonna be pretty chill for the rest of the week. So next week is recess week before midterms exams, so it's gonna be a full week of studying and grinding, and it's gonna be pretty intense. And lastly, we had a few other video shoots as usual. So I have a friend over at Hydragun who sent me this package last night. So if you are like me and have no idea what a Hydragun is, stay tuned to the end of the video because I'm gonna do an unboxing tonight. Okay, it's time for brunch. Okay, so anyways, right now I'm here at Decathlon. I'm hunting for a scooter. So if you guys have watched last week's vlog, I actually tried out this scooter while we were having a video shoot at Esplanade, and I absolutely fell in love with it. So hopefully I can find one here. Let's go. There's a high chance this scooter is gonna spoil on the first day of owning it. Today, I want to talk about building habits that stick in college. You are what you repeatedly do, and if you do something consistently every single day, 365 days a year, you multiply that by the number of years, you can get really good at doing something. The Tamago that you see here today is the result of the good habits that freshman Tamago had repeatedly performed over the last 3 years of university. However, everyone is constrained with the same amount of limited hours in a day, and the only way to get better at more things is if you create good habits that can fit into your schedule so that everything can run on autopilot. So, what exactly is a habit? The book The Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg breaks down habit into a 3-step process, which is cues, which are trigger points that starts a routine, and then a reward, which is like some sort of a positive reinforcement that stimulates us to want to repeat the cycle again and again and again, day after day after day, just to get the reward. Hey! A habit is a formula that our brain automatically follows. When I see a cue, I will do a routine in order to get a reward. So I have 3 main habits that I do in college, which are... Shut up! Come on! Filming a vlog here, man. Okay, we're just gonna ignore the birds. Okay, so I have 3 main habits that I do in college, which are working out, studying, and creating content, such as editing photos for Instagram or creating videos for YouTube. Okay, so here's an example. So one of the biggest cues personally for me that triggers me to want to work out is when I have a cheat meal. So usually when I have like McDonald's or an ice cream, I will really feel like trash after that, and my brain will really crave the feeling of getting a pump or like a healthy exercise in that I usually feel after I get a workout. So this craving comes after the cue triggers a routine, which will then bring me to drag my ass to the gym to get a workout in.
Hey, brother, excuse me. Can you keep quiet? Hey, always working hard, I just got it in my jeans. Think so much, I think my brain is burning calories. I'm mostly quiet, but I'm always wildin' when I drink. To you it's fantasies, but to me it's just like...
Alright, so just to sidetrack a little, for those of you guys who have been following my fitness journey, I know I said that I will be doing a lean bulk next after my last body transformation video, but unfortunately, I have been letting myself go because school has been really shag this semester and I haven't really been tracking my calories. So yeah, anyways, for those of you guys who are curious where I am right now, this is the gym pod at Bishan Ang Mo Kio Park, and it's a really nice cool mini gym in the middle of nowhere that is really good for social distancing. So yeah, check it out. Don't look like a completed bucket list. You know you want some trouble if you're gonna ice. Fun fact, we actually have a new neighbor in the office that is actually a protein distributor, NutriX. So I no longer have to worry about trying to find my protein online anymore. Okay, so another thing that the book highlights, especially for students, is the need for self-discipline and willpower. Students who exerted high levels of willpower were more likely to earn higher grades in their classes and gain admission into better schools. Self-discipline has a bigger effect on academic performance than does intellectual talent. Sometimes it looks like people with great self-control aren't working hard, but that's because they've made it automatic. Their willpower occurs without them having to think about it. So the best way to strengthen self-discipline is to make it a habit, and I do this by making a weekly schedule and to-do list. So the to-do list acts as a cue to trigger the routine, which is either to work or to study. And the satisfaction of ticking the task off the to-do list is the reward that I create. So additionally, you could also add in more rewards to motivate you to make your habits stick. For example, you could visualize how you're gonna get good grades if you are going to study hard, and maybe even being able to get into the university of your dreams, like NUS for example. And even for me, creating this weekly vlog has become a habit that I perform every single week for the past few months, and craving the reward of satisfaction every time I press the upload button every week is what motivates me to trigger the routine, which is to film and edit this videos. As people strengthen their willpower muscles in one part of their lives, in the gym or managing their money, that strength spilled over into what they ate or how hard they worked. Once willpower became stronger, it touched everything. So this brings me to the final and last point of creating keystone habits, which are habits that create a ripple effect of creating other good habits. For example, a simple habit of tracking down your calories can motivate you to eat healthier and exercise more. And for me, my keystone habit is actually my morning routine. So every morning without fail, I will have a glass of water to flush the toxins out of my body. Then I will read my Bible verse of the day, and then I'll make my bed, make a coffee, and then I'll get straight to work. These small wins actually creates a spiral of productivity, and I get even more motivated to go to the gym after that to keep on this winning streak. And by the time I get to the end of the day, I would have already accomplished so much. Okay, so there's actually literature on this, and it's called the progress principle, which basically means making use of these small wins to ignite joy and spark creativity at the workplace. The more frequently you experience that sense of progress, the more likely you are to become more creative and productive at work. Right.
It's a hell of a ride over the east side. It's a hell of a ride. Yeah, wake up out at 6, think about money, think about this. I got nothing on my wrist, but I'll take gladly take your bitch. Ay, 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 who produce that beat? Yeah, ay, yeah, yes sorry, I did, ay.
So right now we're gonna unbox the Hydra gun.
We unbox therapy.
What the? Why so sick one?
You are one of the few athletes we specially selected to send your flashy ever. Looking forward to see what you create.
Hydra gun.
Alright.
They wonder what's the recipe. They want me to come home. I can hear the drum roll, but understand I'm out here for a reason. Living in my own home. Father miss me, I know, but also we know that I'm on a mission. I got diamonds on my feet and shit. Diamonds on my wrist and shit. So icy, bitch, I'm colder than a freezer. Bling, loud. My main bitch, bitch, I'm 21. Side bitch, trippin'. Bitch, I love y'all both, but none of y'all ain't no keepers. I leave, Rolls Royce look.